Hey guys, I think I build the fastest everyday wheelchair. There are lots of builds out there with big motors but almost no usability. And most of them are just mobility scooters rather than actual active wheelchairs. And I'm not just saying that. I've recorded footage of me going 40 kilometers an hour doing wheelies without any problems. Well, there are problems, but not power related. And keep in mind, that's my everyday wheelchair and that's not even a top speed. I have developed a small, lightweight, robust and of course very powerful electric drive for my wheelchair. And in this video, I'm going to show you how I did it. Looking back at the first iteration, there are two major problems. Where to mount the motors and the fact that the pulley was mounted directly to the wheel. The new design is a single, very compact assembly. I'm going to replace the axle adapter and weld the motor plate on there. That way I don't have to worry about where to put the motors. The second big design decision was to have the pulley mounted on the adapter piece using a bearing. This significantly increases the usability, which I will demonstrate later. The adapter and the motor plate are CNC'd out of aluminium to properly support my weight. A friend of mine helped me CNC these parts, so the only thing left to do is weld them together. I have to admit, this is my second time welding, so I'm still gathering experience. Especially aluminium is very tough to weld. At first I had no idea what I'm doing, but I did end up figuring out which configuration and settings work best. That being said, safety is a serious issue. However, as you can see, I am limited to the technology of my apartment. The parts turned out great. Aesthetically, I could have done way better. Also, the surface is uneven and sometimes I should have used way more filler material. However, the parts are fully functional. The last two parts are the pulley and the adapter pieces. At the moment, I'm printing everything using PLA. After using PLA for the first iteration, I can say that the material is well suited for this application. Even after thousands of kilometers, the pulleys work fine. I have to mention that these small adapter pieces are currently designed specifically for my off-road tires. Depending on the tire, the different adapter piece has to be used. Now, assembling the few parts together. Screw in the adapter pieces, screw in the motor, and put a pulley with the belt on. Now, before I'm putting the parts on my wheelchair, I want to talk about the electronics just a bit. I'm going to use the same motor controller as last time, because they are still the best way to go. The VESC is, in my opinion, the most versatile speed controller. You can precisely program the controller to fit the needs of your application. I will be using a 12S system while limiting the phase current of the motors to 60 amps, which equals to about 4.5 kilowatts of power or even 5 kilowatts of power assuming the battery is fully charged and no voltage drop in the cells. When it comes to batteries, I spot weld my own battery packs and use different batteries depending on what I want to do. For testing, I will use this 12S 2P 400 watt hour battery pack. The next step is replacing this adapter piece with my own part. Now all the hardware is done and all that's left is programming the speed controllers. There are many videos out there how to do this, so I will skip this part. And of course, I had to try it out, but it's too much power for my apartment. We have to go outside to fully test both the limits of the electric drive, but also the limit of my everyday wheelchair. And trust me, I did learn from my mistakes. There's more than enough power to go 40 km an hour. I can even start doing wheelies at this speed just by tapping the throttle. I control both motors with a single remote. That way I have both hands on my wheelchair. Because I'm a paraplegic, this gives me stability and control. I can precisely brake without me catapulting myself out of my own wheelchair. I do have regenerative braking, which I use. However, when I'm braking with full force at high speed, I can feel my body shifting to the front and almost out of my wheelchair. That's why I want to keep my hands on the wheels at all times. Wheelies at high speeds are relatively easy to pull off. I have a steady throttle, which is usually so much that I'm about to fall over, but I fine-tune the tipping point of my wheelchair by braking with my hands. Another important topic when it comes to wheelchairs is torque. The electric drive has roughly 25 Nm of torque on each side, which is not much considering the size of the wheels. However, I am able to get up most hills as long as I don't fall over. So more torque wouldn't help, and more power wouldn't help either. Going high speed in just the wheelchair is very dangerous. Every time I brake, my whole weight shifts to the front tires and I feel like I'm about to crash. That's why I use this handcycle for stability. I can just attach it to my wheelchair, usually to work out, but today we are going to test the top speed. In the corner you can also see the power output of both motors. The power does not exceed 2.5 kW because for the first tests I have set the current rating to 60 amps. But it should be more than enough. You can see that the 50 km an hour are no problem. And the ride itself is much smoother than with just the wheelchair. Going fast, the power consumption is extremely high. I guess wheelchairs are just not meant to be aerodynamic. Now, remember when I talked about the usability of this design? I can very easily remove the wheels and put them back on really quick. The only downside is that the whole system adds just under 2 kg of weight to my wheelchair, of course without battery. But in my opinion, 2 kg is almost nothing considering the quality of life I get from this electric drive. Now, I showed you all those clips with full power, going fast, doing wheelies. But to be honest, I don't even use it like that. In the end, I really appreciate the possibilities and the independence it gives me. Before I end this video, I want to say that I'm not selling this as a product. This is just a DIY project. That's why I decided to share all the parts I've used. This project is open source, so anyone can download the files for free. If you have any questions, please comment below. I appreciate any like, so more people may find this project. Thank you for watching.